Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, and it's Artcast number 46. Sorry I didn't get a show up yesterday. I just didn't feel well, and I don't know, I was kind of having a little bit of an art crisis kind of thing, which happens to me every now and then. And I just didn't want to get on here and talk, because I knew I was going to just complain and all sorts of stuff, so I just thought, nah, I'm just going to let it go. Probably do one on Saturday, kind of make up for it. I want to keep my consistency going. It was kind of nice, though. I got some really cool comments. Soferia was one of them. And, I don't know, she had some just super cool, nice things to say, and I appreciate that a ton. It's just nice, it's inspiring. And Peter actually had some nice stuff to say too. Peter Palmiotti, who does some art casts also. Does one a day. And man, it's like I've been kind of falling behind on them a little bit. Just because I've been starting listening to them, and then for whatever reason, I don't get quite through them. And then before I know it, there's like another one, and then I think, oh, well, I'll listen to that one after I go back and listen to the other one. And then pretty soon there's like another one. And I don't know. The daily videos are almost kind of hard to keep up with. I wonder if you guys are having that kind of problem with me. Like a little too much content. I wouldn't doubt it. But yeah, I don't know. I'm doing a nude tonight. Just wanted to kind of do something a little different. I don't know. I want to explore it a little bit. I want to just try to do a few different things, just to see if there's like, if one of them's kind of like sought after in a way, you know what I mean? I just want to do a few different things, put them up, and if there's one that kind of really stands out, maybe it's a direction I should really push in. I mean, obviously, what I'm doing now is working, working better and better every day, it seems like. Dang it, there's like a little mosquito in here now. So on the web, there's like a YouTube video of somebody making like a mosquito trap. I don't mind trying it, because I think I suck some mosquitoes in here when I stick the fans in the windows. And I know some flying around in here at night. And then, you know, like, it's not that big a deal, because I usually, since I have the fans blasting, I think the air is moving around in here at night. And but then I turn off the fan, like, so I can do these podcasts or whatever they are, artcasts. And then the mosquitoes can kind of, you know, fly around better because the wind isn't blowing them around, so they kind of start dive bombing me, I notice. But anyway, I saw, like, on a video, somebody making a mosquito trap is what they called it. And they, like, took a bottle, like a bottle of Pepsi, you know, kind of one of those taller ones. And they cut the top off, and then inside it, I think they put water, brown sugar, and what was the other thing? Oh, yeast. I think it was something like a cup of water, and like a fourth of a cup of brown sugar or something. And then, you know, a good scoop, looked like maybe at least a full tablespoon of yeast. And then they took the top of the bottle and they like flipped it over and stuck it back in, so the round part with the little nozzle or whatever was sticking down in there. And then the bottle sat down here with all the mixture down here, and so I guess the mosquitoes would go down that funnel or whatever and get in there, and then they couldn't get back out for some reason. That's what they said anyway. I thought maybe I'd try it. If I could kind of catch some of these little boogers. I don't know. I'm already like looking forward to the summer being over, but I don't know though. Tristan's actually got to go to school this year now. His first year of preschool. And, I don't know, it's just, I mean, it's good, but as a dad, you're kind of like, oh, man, he's got to go through all that stuff now, you know? But maybe he'll be like a kid that likes school. I didn't like school much when I was in school. I don't know if I didn't do very well. I wasn't like an A student. I really was kind of like this kid that lived in his own mind a little bit. And so I didn't care about school much. I wanted to get home and play with my friends and do all the stuff that I cared about, you know. And I always looked at school as kind of like this thing I had to do before I could go and, you know, have fun and stuff. But my fun wasn't like bad fun. It was, I think it was good fun. But I don't know. Gotta learn how to read and write, right? He's just such a little guy. He went to the post office with me today, and they always kind of, I don't know. You know, you said he can be so shy sometimes, and all the ladies now, people, mainly the ladies though, that work there, have kind of taken it upon themselves to get him to like say hi to him or like smile at him and things like that. And they used to kind of be able to do it when he was littler, but now he's like, I think he's even gotten a little bit more shy. And he hadn't went to the post office with me for a little while. And then all of a sudden now we're going again, and I don't think he really remembers when they were kind of like trying to make him laugh as a baby and stuff. And he just, I don't know, man. He does not. He does not want to talk to him. And he just kind of gets behind me, like I'll be standing here, and then like he'll be here, and then like if the camera is like them trying to talk to him, he'll get like straight behind me. And then if somebody comes over here, like he'll kind of like ease around and like just so he's always like straight behind me, so that they can't quite see him, you know. He's pretty funny. He's also taking swimming lessons, too. He was taking soccer lessons, which the soccer lessons were pretty much just a free-for-all run around and jump over stuff. They weren't doing a lot of soccer. But, I think it's good. I was a little worried that he might get scared of the water, being so young, and going to swimming lessons. They're with his mom, though. Tanya takes him and she swims with him and stuff, so it's not like he's just going to some random place. I don't think he could hack that at this point. But I was worried he's going to get scared because my younger brother did that. Like, I went to swimming lessons as a kid. Like, my grandma didn't know how to swim, and she was really adamant about us knowing how to swim for some reason. She used to always say, everybody should know how to swim. That was one of her things. She had like lots of different things that she said. But she kind of, like, if you want to know what my grandma was like, she was the spitting image of the old granny in the movie Every Which Way But Loose. Can't remember her name though. She's like a pretty famous actress. But I don't know if anybody remembers that movie, but there's like a scene in it where she's rocking in the rocking chair. The bikers come looking for Clint Eastwood. It's the one with Clint Eastwood and the monkey, you know, where he's got the orangutan as a pet. And they're like, I don't know, trying to like intimidate her into like, you know, telling them where I think Clint Eastwood leaves or something, and he goes after this girl actually. And so these bikers are just, it's kind of like a subplot. They're trying to find him to like beat him up because he beat up this biker guy. And then like, you know, I think they're like breaking stuff off the porch and stuff. And then she like pulls out the shotgun and starts shooting at him. Well, that's the spitting image of my grandma. She was definitely like a little old lady that was like rocking on the porch that probably had a big gun underneath her or knitting, but anyway, back to the point, is like Tristan's taking swimming lessons, and my brother, you know, like me and him went to do swimming lessons when we were kids, and I loved it. I don't know, I've always really liked swimming and all that stuff, and but my brother, you know, he was 3 years younger than me, my middle brother, and he got scared at like an early age, you know what I mean, like before, I think he went before he was ready, and then he was kind of like always scared of jumping off the diving board and things like that, and it stuck with him his whole life, I mean. So I was kind of worried that that would happen to Tristan if he went, you know, because I mean, man, he's never even been to a pool and he's going to go to like swimming lessons. It sounded sort of intimidating to me, but and he's already a shy kid, you know. But he did good, I guess. I guess he did really good, and you know, he likes it. So they're even going to the pools on other days now too. So that's pretty neat. Yeah, my one brother Keith, and you know, he's like the one who's 3 years younger than me. He even like to this day, he doesn't like to go out on a boat and things like that. Which is funny because he fishes, and he fishes out of like a sea kayak thing now. And but just on the lakes around here, not like out in the ocean or anything, which are pretty tame, but. I was really surprised when he showed me his little boat. I was like, what the hell? You bought a boat? Are you kidding me? You hate the water. He used to always get freaked out about the dark, too. Oh, no. We used to go fishing together. I remember this one time when we, it stays with him. Something about him, he really, once he gets, like, scared of something, it sticks with him. Not that he's, like, scared of stuff. He's probably a lot tougher than me, you know, 90% of the time, but I remember he never liked being out in the woods at night, and I don't know, when you go fishing, you know, you go hike in somewhere, and then you stay too long, and then pretty soon you're hiking out in the dark, you know, and it's scary, but I remember that we did that one time, this reservoir, hiked down this god-awful, you know, side of a mountain to get down to this one side of it. And then stayed too long, you know. And then climbed out, like, you know, pretty much in the dark. And he just was not digging it. He was pissed at me for staying too long. But, yeah, I don't fish anymore. I haven't fished in a long time. It's one of those things I like doing with him, but I don't know if I like doing it just by myself. But I kind of want to take Tristan like camping or something too, though. I think that would be fun. We lived up in the mountains for a while at this place called Ward. Not in this town called Ward, because Ward is like this hippie little town that's just a total weirdoville. But we lived outside of there. We lived off in the mountains away from there. And, that really got me out of doing it because I lived up there. So, you know, it was just like, it seemed like why go somewhere with a tent when you got a bed right here and we're already, you know, looking at probably, you know, more rugged of mountains than we'd even find if we went looking from somewhere else, so. But, I don't know, it is fun. Tristan would probably really dig it though. Yeah, I don't know if I got much more to say. Thanks for all the awesome comments. Did I show you the new print? Oh man, I forgot to say talk about this. I always hate that when I forget this stuff because I want to advertise it and then I don't. Because I'm off on some other topic and then there's probably only 3 people watching the video at this point. But here's my new print. Check it out. It's pretty cool. But anyway, yeah, I'm going to get going back on the print thing again, start listing all these and making prints and selling prints and all that stuff. So, this is the first one I did. which I've been doing prints. It's just I haven't been, you know, on it with the new stuff, but yeah, came out really nice. I love how this printer is printing these things. So 13 by 19, this image is 11 by 14, so it would fit in a mat or something if you wanted to do it that way. And I tweeted out and Facebooked out, like, I do a little drawing on the first five I sell, like a little Wolverine or, you know, Hulk or something down here in the corner. And yeah, I don't know, I already got 3 sales, so there's 2 left. If you want in on it, go hit the button and buy one. Well, there you guys go. I realize it's like I really want to get a few more paintings going. I've been doing a lot of drawings and not as many paintings. So I never used to make prints of my drawings until I think it was Chris Mason wanted those prints of the Robin Hood piece. I did like 3 little roughs that came out pretty cool. And he was like, I want to buy those things. And I thought, well, I guess I can make prints of my drawings. And I liked liked them so much that when they came out, that I thought, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and start doing that now. And that's really cool. But the only thing is, it's like I have, I don't know, I have so many. I've just been doing a ton of drawings lately, though, that I realize. And I really want to try to get more paintings in. But it's just reflecting the market at this point. I'm not making a ton. I mean, I've seen a few people comment here and there about, you know, my stuff is going for too low. And yeah, I agree, but, you know, it's the market dictating what my stuff's going to bring right now. So it's going to go up in the future. It's already going up. But it's just something I got to get through right now. As the audience builds and grows and, you know, and as people get used to buying stuff and want more stuff and all that thing, you know, it's just a cycle that, you know, just like any artist, whether you're selling in a gallery or even working as an illustrator or whatever, you got to start out where you can start out, get a hold of like that little bit that you can get hold of, and then let that thing grow, you know. I do appreciate everybody's buying stuff from me too. I don't know if I mentioned that enough, really. I'm always talking about Patreon, and which I appreciate the Patreon people too, but I mean, shoot, you know, it's like the people that are buying stuff are really the ones that are, you know, making it work for me. And I never really talk about any of them. So, anyway. You guys are awesome. Yeah, I think this one's coming out pretty good. I had this reference, I don't know, I pulled it a while ago. And I was like, I thought it would make a really cool piece. Just I like the way, you know, her legs are kind of the shape, so it's like a taller figure, but then like with her legs out like this, it kind of makes it just the design of it, you know, rather than just like a standing nude or something like that. I just like the way it kind of bounces down like that. So I wanted to do it, and I don't know. I just sometimes I'm leery about doing nudes anymore because I don't want to offend anyone, you know, especially people who are into my fan art. I know, like, there's, you know, different girls and stuff that buy from me, and I just don't want to offend anybody if they would be inclined to be offended, I guess. I don't know. But I don't know. I do like to draw nudes once in a while. So, and I don't know if I mentioned that in this one or not, but I kind of wanted to try some different things. I'm going to kind of start allotting a little bit of time every week to just trying some different stuff. So, because I want to see what markets are there. You know what I mean? And It's just there's other stuff that I do and I've sold in the past, and I just kind of wonder, you know, because it's like if I can hit that hot market, you know, it's just going to help me. It's going to help me do everything I need to do. And maybe I am on it right now, and that's awesome, but, you know, like I think I've told the story. I started, when I first started selling art, I sold nudes exclusively, you know. And it was good. It was good money at that time. And, you know, it just gets me thinking. It just gets me thinking out there, is there like kind of, you know, fans that want a certain thing? Not that I'll do anything, but, I don't know. I don't mind the kind of the variety, some, you know what I mean? It's just like, when I do something a little different for a couple days and I feel like getting back on, you know, whatever I'm supposed to be doing even more, you know. It's kind of like when I'm doing a commission and I jump off it for a little bit and do a few things, and it's like it makes me want to get back on that commission, and it inspires me, and a lot of times it kind of takes me through. So, I mean, just like drawing. I've been doing so many drawings, I've really wanted to do some paintings lately, so. I mean, I imagine there's probably going to be some more paintings coming. But I don't know. There's just a few different things that are in the back of my mind. Some of, like, my fantasy stuff, too. It just kind of made me think. It's like, I wonder if any of that would sell. Is there a market out there? Could I kind of do it at the same time I'm doing this other stuff? You know, it just doesn't hurt to put something up and see what happens, right? And too, you know, like the other thing about it is I am an illustrator, you know. I am open to that kind of work if somebody's got some. I've got a few things that might come up that are like that. I mean, I don't know if you guys remember that mermaid thing I did as a sketch a while ago. But, you know, I don't know. It's just, I don't know, you know, when your portfolio starts going like one way so hard, it's almost like I kind of want to, I don't know if I want variety in it, but just, I just want to be open and ready for whatever comes along, whatever opportunities come along, you know. I know that comment that, you know, like a lot of times people are just like, oh, is this all you do, fan art, or, you know, blah, blah, blah. It's like, can you only draw from photos, can't draw over your head, all that BS. It drives me crazy, you know. But it's like, sometimes I go to my site and I look and I'm like, well, no wonder they think that, because it's like there's so much of it. You really got to dig to find something else, you know. But on the other side of that too, I'm like, you know, what's the difference, you know? There's a guy just got on the Artcasters Facebook group, and I don't know, I should remember his name. Maybe I'll try to remember it for tomorrow. His name's Steve something. He's doing watercolor, like tutorial kind of videos right now. Looks pretty good. I'm interested in seeing some more of those, and also just kind of, just because I'm also a little bit interested in watercolor myself, you know, and I could never, or I just don't have the desire to really learn the kind of classic watercolor techniques and stuff, but I'm always looking to add stuff to what I already do. There was a girl too, what's her name? Lachri or something, Fine Art on YouTube. Should have, like, maybe I'll look these guys up. I'll stick them in the show notes. I'll make a note of it, and I'll stick them in the show notes so you guys can see who I'm talking about. But that guy, Steve, and then there's this other one. And I think her name's something like Lachri Fine Art or something. And she does color pencil. But then she does it in this more kind of classic fine art way, where they mix they actually blend the colors. Like, they don't do any watercolor or anything like that as a wash or a base. And she blends the color pencil with man, it's like, come on, Jeff, get to the point. She blends it with odorless paint thinner. So basically she's like drawing an area, and then she'll like kind of like blend it a little bit with or not blend it, but it's like it, you know, wets up the wax and stuff in the color pencil, and it gets into the paper, so it kind of gets rid of all those little white marks, like as if you were trying to just draw straight colored pencil. It'd be tough to kind of get like a consistent, you know, color without kind of, you know, just like this stuff that I'm drawing, where it's sort of like the real grainy look of the color pencil, which I like right here, but I wouldn't, you know, I don't want it everywhere, you know, especially if I was trying to render this out all nice and perfect. But I just thought that was super interesting. And she's got a lot of stuff on there, like a lot more of a fine art type perspective, and it's good. It's actually really good. They're good videos. I should actually share them. Share a couple on the Artcasters group, so you guys can know what I'm talking about. And then there's also another one, another girl, Leilani Joy or something like that, I think. And she's actually, she's a pretty good artist, but I mean, she's good at selling and actually building a following on YouTube and stuff. And she's like big time on Etsy, just killing it on Etsy, and so really impressive. So I don't know if anybody's watching her, but she's another one to watch. She kind of reminds me of that Val's Art Diary. When I first got on YouTube and was kind of looking around for models to, or business models, not models, you know, to sell, or how people were doing it, how people were making it work. There was a chick who was really making it work, that Val's Art Diary. I don't know if she eventually just got out of it and got a job, or if she just started selling in fine arts, or what. I see her kind of come back every now and again, but I just haven't heard anything out of her for like a long time. But man, she was just killing it on YouTube for the longest time. And her whole thing was like, she'd do a painting, and one painting a week. And at first she was selling them on eBay, and they were all just abstracts and stuff like that. You know, she just had a quirky personality and had like a ton of subscribers to her channel, and it just grew and grew. And, you know, it's something that, in a way, like as artists, you know, I know everybody's like, oh, you can't make any money with art, we're at the biggest disadvantage of everybody. But it's actually something where we have an advantage, because we actually make something to sell at the end of this. Other YouTube people, they don't have anything to sell on eBay or something, you know what I mean? They do a Patreon, they don't have prints to give away and stuff, you know? So in that sense, you know, before you write yourself off as like, oh, you can't do anything, you know, you should think about that. I mean, actually, we have like a huge advantage over so many different things, because, you know, I went to the store this week and I picked up black color pencils, I picked up a tube of white paint, and like three sheets of this gray paper, and I got a few other things, a brush and some stuff, but it was like around $30 or something like that. And, you know, over the next week I'll turn that $30 into, you know, a hell of a lot more. And it's like, that's just, you know, not me, it's like all of us, you know what I mean? We all just go and we make stuff out of like practically thin air, and can charge like a ton of money for it. So there's your guys' pep talk today. Anyway, I guess I'm going to wrap it up. I hope that was a good video for you guys. And thanks for sticking with me. Like I said, sorry I didn't get one out on Thursday. And I'll probably end up doing one for Saturday. We'll see. It's always just so dead. Whenever I put up a Saturday video, though, it just seems like nobody sees it. So, but yeah, I don't know. I think I will, because I want to keep up with my schedule, you know what I mean? 5 videos a week. It's working. So everything's working well. So, and there's some guys on the Artcaster side I know noticed they're talking about doing some videos and, you know, giving it a try, talking about cameras and stuff. It's a pretty cool group. Everybody should join it. But to all those guys, I want to say go for it, you know. Definitely get yourself a camera and record something and put it up before you can, like, nitpick it to death and talk yourself out of it. Because that's what we do as artists, you know. We all just do this great thing, and then we go, well, I don't know if I should have done that. I don't know why I'm putting stuff up on Etsy. I shouldn't probably do, you know what I mean? Something on eBay. Oh, you should. You should get that stupid voice out of your head, actually. Anyway, there you guys go. I'll see ya. I don't know when I'll see ya. Sometime. And don't forget about those prints. Couple left if you guys want to buy one. Get a little sketch on it. Go for it. It's over at my Store Envy site, and you can find that off my website, jefflafferty.net. See you guys.